Good morning. Today you would like to discuss the theory of Rangers de Mise. Rangers go back to 1872, however their fans hark back to a time before. To a time when William of Orange was around. He was a Dutch mercenary who once fought on behalf of the Pope, and who eventually fought the Catholic King of England. For years it was Rangers' policy not to sign Catholics, they were a predominantly Protestant club. Recent history shows that they exerted their majesty's revenue and customs from millions of pounds of tax, robbing the people of the United Kingdom of much-needed hospitals, schools, and much more. Even with all the stolen money to hand, they could not buy success in Europe. They brought in big-name players like Flo, Gascoigne, and Attilaye. But to no avail, they did win at a domestic level. But after the investigations, those titles were stripped from them. Eventually, the taxman caught up with them, their revered father Ali stated. We don't blow the king away. But, one by one they did, first Murray, then Jelavich, soon Zelig, and Wild. Followed, this slow evacuation soon became an exodus. Das S.F.A. deducted 30 points, and with the lack of talent, Rangers were relegated. Soon das loyal fans, fervently sang about buying up to their knees in Finian blood. Also deserted the team, eventually Rangers were playing to crowds of under 900, a bit like the early 80s. The father, Ali, had enough, he retreated to his bunker, and has never been seen again, fell. Apart from question of sport reruns on Dave, Ibrox, was soll to Tesco. And all that is left is a plaque on the wall, saying, Rangers F.C. Born 1872. Died 2013. They are all but forgotten now. A few rusty reruns on Sky Sports is all that is left of them. I'm just glad that I have always been a Celtic supporter. Jelly and ice cream anyone? Hail hell. Everyone. Hail.